So I don't know. I know that you say that you like to do only the the double strand twists. Mm-hmm. But I find that, and I know a lot of people, especially in the winter time, they don't want to do wash and goes because they kind of feel that they need to do like a protective style in their hair. And I've just found, like, with myself and, you know, feedback from other people, that as long as you are moisturizing your hair, it's going to be protected. And, you know, you just don't want to, once you put all the products in your hair and it dries, the difference is that you just don't want to manipulate the curls anymore, because that's also how you disturb the curl and you get frizz. I know I have like hand in hair syndrome, mm-hmm. especially too. Back here. I'm like, I'm driving, I'm just like, oh, man. And Candy already like washed and conditioned her hair, so it's just wet. There's no product or anything in her hair. So we're starting with her hair damp. And when you're working with curly hair, I know some people like to do like dry detangling, or even just do like work with the hair dry. I like to work with my hair wet. I just find that it's just easier to get the product throughout. It's easier to detangle. So I always work with wet hair. And then I like to use, these are the duckbill clips.
That's what you need.
And this is perfect for separating your hair. And then when you're ready to dry your hair, I use these to hold my hair back. Because I hate my hair like on my face. I'm just one of those people. So I'm always pulling it back. And I was like at Panera all day like this. And I was like, I don't care what you're doing. My hair gotta look good tonight. So I'm just going to section her hair. Because working in sections, it just makes it easier. And especially because, you know, like our hair, curly hair, there's like different textures going on in there, right? Mm-hmm. So when you section it this way, and I'm glad that her hair is the same length as mine, because this is exactly what I do in my hair.
Actually, when I went and got the cut, I took your picture. I should confess, and it's growing out, and then you cut it again, and I was just telling her, do you know she cut it again and messed me up? And when I went to the salon, they were like, who is that? I said, I don't know, Wonder Curl, can you do this?
Well, now I have a picture of the size.
I waved it in my phone, but I'm trying to grow it out.
Obsessed.
Oh, you're growing it out? Like,
yeah, I am obsessed.
There's a show called Stalker.
Love it.
I love it because it wasn't a severe pop that you had. That's what I liked about it.
Oh, okay.
Because I've seen some that's just severe and it's sticking straight up. And I have done that too.
Right.
I feel like getting crazy with it. I put a lot of gel and just make it stand straight up. Yeah, that's my stalker story.
Well, thank you. Well, you know, I was thinking of cutting all my hair like Candy next. Oh, that was like my next.
You've been there too.
I've been there too. Yeah. Shaved sides, designs in my head, mm-hmm. longer hair. Yeah, I had designs because I started out with long natural, and then I was like, no, I can't. I got to.
She thinks she looks plain with the long hair.
Yeah, and when you do something funky and weird, you just stand out.
I agree.
Yeah,
I agree. I was like, you know,
see,
I was tired of having.
Not me. I look awful.
I think there's a short haircut for everybody. It's just finding the look for you.
Absolutely.
Yep. All right, you know, I'm going to ask you to just turn a little bit. So like you can see, like, I'm just adding the smoothie to her hair, and already you can see, like, a little bit of the definition showing through. And I'm just going to, I put too much on my hands. I'm going to work it throughout on the sides and everything. See, now you can just shave the sides now because it's, like, the perfect length. All right. Twins. All right. So I like to do it this way, or if I'm in a rush, I'll probably like work all of the smoothie throughout my hair first, and then I just like that's what I did this morning. I was like, I'm in a rush. I gotta check out. So at first, I just put everything in, and then I layered the lotion on top. But I did it in. But even when I layer it, I still layer it in sections. So I'm just adding like a little bit. And then you use your fingers to rake it through. And that's how you get that clumping, is with your fingers. So, like, don't be, I know, like, some people might be afraid to go in. Like, you're not going to break it. Like, go right in. And you see how I'm just, like, raking it through. And as I'm raking it, that's what's causing the curls. And the more you manipulate it, the more you see the curls are coming out. And this is a technique that works, like, on all different, like, with any kind of product. So it's not just, you know, my product that's going to do that. It's just that your hair is probably going to last longer with my
products. And which one did you just use? The.
So first I put the smoothie
in. The smoothie, okay.
So kind of like with the LOC method, you want to do like the liquid. And to me, like the liquid is, you know, having the hair wet already. Mm-hmm. The oil, like I don't work with straight oil. Like I said, like I prefer to do a cream because creams, A, they're easier to distribute throughout your hair and they already have some kind of moisture in it. My products are all aloe based. So I like using aloe vera and that is a moisture because aloe is like water. So this is kind of like that liquid oil combo. And then I don't use a cream. I prefer a styler, especially in the summer or winter, because like in this summer, because there's so much moisture already in the air, using just a cream, using just like a shea butter, it's gonna seal in the moisture, but it's not going to keep any of the humidity out. And that's why a lot of people find that their hair frizzes, tends to frizz in the summer, because you need some kind of styler. And that's the styler is going to keep the water from coming out of your hair. No, they're going to keep the water from going into your hair. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's what I mean. And the lotion is just going to give her like softer, fluffier curls.
Mm, that's great.
Yeah, and the more you use, you know, the more definition you're going to have. And I'm pretty heavy-handed with my products and my hair. Like, I just love my hair to be super defined. And you're just gonna like continue the process throughout your hair. And one of the reasons why it's good to section it is A, you can gauge like where the different curl patterns are, where it's thicker in some sections. And when that happens is, you know, you can add a little bit more. So usually I find that the center part of your hair is like the thickest part of your hair, so I like to add a little bit more to that part of my hair just because of that reason. And feel free to ask me any questions like as I'm doing this as well.
I did have a question. Your products, would you recommend them for children?
Yeah.
Okay.
How old are your kids?
19, 16, 12, and 4. Everybody's like, I'm thinking.
Yeah. Yeah. It's, you know, anyone can use it from, you know, the age 1 and up. There's nothing in it that's going to harm the hair.
Perfect,
you know.
Yeah. That's what you find with, you know, with products. My oldest daughter, she's a different story. She just decided to perm her hair. But she's 19, that's her business. But my youngest daughter has like a really thick hair, and like you said, it's just it always looks dry by the end of the day, and she has a whole lot of hair.
Mm-hmm.
So like even when I put it in ponytails and such like that, like, you know, we'll see a TV show. She's like, Mom, you put my afro and look just like that. My point, but of course, by the end of the day,
yeah,
know, she has shrinkage for days. So it's just like, you know, so I'm watching how her hair is just becoming so, it has beautiful definition.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And if I use the jelly, it would just define it even more.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'll use the jelly on the sides so that it'll be a little bit tighter and you can also see the difference in the two products. But you can see like how it's just holding the curl pattern in. And that's just what it does. Like, it enhances your natural curl pattern. I let people know, like, it's not gonna look like my hair, my hair's not gonna look like yours. And that's the nice thing about, I think, the natural hair movement is about appreciating your hair as it grows out of your head. Because it's like, believe it or not, there was a time when I hated my hair, and I was just like, what the heck is going on here? You hear my jersey coming out? So it took me some time to finally understand my hair and just love what's happening with it. And like everyone else, I went through the whole process of figuring it out, learning what worked. But also, you know, I've had people along the way who tried to deter me from going natural, and tried to stop me, or even when I did go natural, they're like, you sure you don't want a permit? You sure you don't want a relaxer? I'm like, no. I was like, I'm struggling, but I'm not going back. So
I think my biggest problem is that, because all of my hair is about the same length, the top of her hair, and I get frustrated because I wanted to have this boom pow look, and if it doesn't have that, I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna put it up, and that's right. What I've done. I just put it up.
And what do you mean by boom pow?
I wanted to shock me when I look at it. Boom pow. Yeah. Shock me when I look at it.
I would love to have her curls.
Yeah.
No, you have to love your curls.
I'm learning to learn.
Confusing. They're confused. My curls.
It's a thing.
Yes.
Boom pow. Confusing.
I want to wear my hair like that in the more of a natural state, but I have horrible shrinkage. It can go from my shoulders when it's wet to like.
You went way over there.
To like around
3 inches.
And it's like, I'll put gel in it or something, and it looks really nice and cute. But the moment I go outside, it just is over.
Yeah, it's definitely products. You know, there's just a lot of products that claim they're going to define the curls or keep it from getting frizzy, and they just don't. They don't do that at all. And that's why I was like, I have to make my own, because it was just so depressing. And not only that, but and some of them, you know, it was like the process was just so hard and tedious. I'm like, it has to be easier than this. Because at the time, before I started making Wonder Curl, or even before I came up with the gel, I was using coconut oil, aloe gel by... was it Earth, one of those products? But it was just like straight up aloe vera that you would use on a sunburn. A leave-in conditioner that was expensive because it was so hard back then to find a conditioner that was like thick enough, but also worked with a gel. And then I used this Structura Curl Lotion, which you could only get from New York. And it was just one salon that made it, and it helped to define the curls. So I used like these 4 products on my hair, but it only worked when it wasn't humid outside, you know? And so it was just like so just frustrating and hard, and especially like living in Florida by the beach, you know, everyone would just watch your hair grow. And you're like, I spent 2 hours on my hair. Why does this happen? So, you know, I'm going to use the pudding and the jelly on her side, just so that you guys could kind of see the difference. You can see, like, with the pudding, it's a little bit thicker. So if you wanted something that helped to seal in moisture better, then I would suggest using the pudding in your hair. And it's like, as soon as I put it in her hair, I could feel it just getting softer. And you can see, like, a little bit of the definition coming through. Let me turn your head to the side. But I'm going to add the jelly. Oh, thanks.
Me next.
Scarlett, you made me want to take my ponytail out.
We have time. So
I'm done. I've had my hair that short. I've had my hair, well, pretty much all you can see is the color. I've cut my hair way off.
Wow.
Couple times.
Well,
looks very nice on
her.
Yeah. It's just, you know, sometimes you gotta switch things up.
Yeah.
I'm not brave. I can't cut it.
Me either. I'm happy to get the little bit I got.
Yeah, it's an accessory, but
my sisters are the same way. Like
they just won't cut.
They won't cut it. They're like, my hair was short. I'm like, shoulder length is not short.
It is when you're natural and it shrinks up.
Well,
because yeah. Mine is to my shoulder, but you couldn't tell. Like in the back, yeah.
But I think sometimes people confuse natural is supposed to be this length of natural instead mm-hmm. of just being who you are.
Right.
It's natural. You know? Yeah. Mm-hmm. But we still have this European thought process, you know?
Yeah.
Of how natural is supposed to be that natural instead of just being who it is.
I think I just got mine because my mom used to always be like, your hair's your glory, girl. That's where your beauty lies.
My daughter's grandmother was like that when she was in Ohio for the summer. She's like, Roz, you want to perm her hair? No. I'm like, she decided, she's 16 now, but she decided when she was 12 that she didn't want to perm her hair anymore. And I'm fine with that.
My daughter was 8 and she's like, no more.
That's awesome. My 8-year-old, I said, I will never. After doing it with the first three.
Yeah, my daughter experienced breakage when she was 8 years old, and she was like, just don't put it back in. I was like, okay.
Damn. That's terrible. Well, the biggest, the best part of being natural for me has been my scalp is not irritated. Mm-hmm. It was a creamy crack. I was going through it. Like, I could get my hair washed one day, by like day three, it's like it's snowing on my shoulders. Ooh. And now... no problem, it doesn't itch, it feels so light. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking like I should have did this long time ago, just from the strength of this alone.
It's one of those like, why didn't I do this sooner? Like, right. Why did I wait? But like you, like my parents were the same way, and I'm patient. Mm-hmm. So it's just like that, you know, women have to have long hair,
right.
And that's just your femininity.
Right.
You know, when I came home, the first time I cut my hair off, they were like, what did you do?
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, you'll never find a job with that hair. Like, why would you do that?
Mm-hmm. Same way my mom did.
I just graduated from college. Mm-hmm. And, like, I graduated, and a week later, I went back to the salon. I was like, cut it off. I'm like, I'm done. And, you know, and I haven't looked back since, and I'm glad.
Mm-hmm.
And now they finally accepted it. And oddly enough, when I cut my hair off in June, my dad was like, it's cute. Who is this?
Like, what?
Yeah. I was like, you fellow, in your old age, man. I was like, I like it. My mother took her a while, and I think she's going to freak out when she sees this.
Oh, she hasn't seen that yet?
Well, she saw it as, it was a little less defined as a frohawk, so it looked more like, I would say, like, people kept calling it
undercut.
A TWA froze type situation.
Thing. Yeah, but it was a taper TWA.
Okay.
So people kept calling it taper TWA.
Gotcha.
And I'm like, it's not a taper TWA.
So you cut off more.
Yeah. So I just had her cut the size and like trim the top a little bit. But this is it. Like, so you can see the difference.
Looks nice.
Between, so you can see like how fluffy it is in the middle, and then it's a little bit more defined in the sides.
Turn your head back.
So you can see all.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Now you can see the style.
How long does your product last? Say you use it every day. How long would that one container last you?
Well, I don't restyle my hair every day. So when my hair was longer, I used to, and I'll give you a mirror so you can see what you look like.
Okay.
And you let me know, like, if you want me to, like, cascade it to the side or if you like it.
Oh, just do
it.
She don't care.
No, I wear my hair anytime. You can definitely see the curls.
I think
it. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's what you think.
What's your name?
You her type of friend.
Oh, yes.
No, that's what you think.
Before you came in, that she's put letters.
You know, the only thing that I have done is color. And I just told my sister, because my hair has always been so sensitive to color. So I've never went that far.
I've been.
But like now, I want that color. I just told my sister, I said, I want my hair red.
Six colors in one month.
She said pink, orange.
Yes.
No, it wasn't on purpose though. It's pink and orange by accident.
Oh, really?
You told the pink and orange story? But it was cool.
Yeah.
You know,
know, until you find like what you really like, and if you have, if make sure you don't have like any other.